Hi, I'm Nic Natarella with AdWise Creative. You've been producing your podcast like crazy. I'm going to give them a little something to make them stand out. Have you thought about sound effects? Sometimes they're appropriate, sometimes they're not. We're going to go over how you can do it and how to do it properly and if you should do it to begin with. Let's do it next. So what are the two ways to add sound effects to your podcast? There's a right way and a wrong way, and two techniques. Let's dive into both of those, okay? We'll get you editing like a pro. When I took my first audio class back in college, the very first assignment was the opening scene from Beverly Hills Cop, the classic Eddie Murphy movie. And if you remember the opening scene, it's where he's an undercover cop trying to sell illegal cigarettes, an entire semi-tractor trailer full of cigarettes. Well, these two guys, his potential buyers, are standing there. The three of them are talking. And unbeknownst to them, a real cop car pulls into the back and notices some stuff going on. Well, when they pull up to try and figure out what the heck's going on, that's when the bad guys jump in the truck. Eddie Murphy is still in the back in the semi part, and the truck takes off. And for about 3 to 5 minutes, it's nothing but truck driving through neighborhoods and all kinds of mayhem. There were truck sounds. There were chain rattling sounds. There was dog barking sounds. There were all traffic sounds, skidding tires, crashing cars, all kinds of stuff throughout that entire time. And as the assignment, we had to go through and listen to those. Each one of us got a cassette tape. I'm dating myself here. We got a cassette tape of the scene. And that was our homework, to listen to that scene over and over and over again until we had all the sound effects listed out in the proper order. I really don't remember, but I want to say everybody had over 150 sound effects listed in that short amount of time. Over 150. And there were some that half of us were like, "What? I didn't catch that." And the person was like, "Listen," they'd hit play, and sure enough, there it was. We missed it. But it was crucial. The sound effects could make or break the scene. The same is true for your podcast. Sometimes it's appropriate, and quite frankly, sometimes it's not. If it's not the right time or place, please don't put it in there. It's going to be distracting. It's going to be incongruous to what you're trying to say and what you're trying to teach or do, and it's just going to distract from the whole thing. So how do you determine if it's appropriate or not? Well, first, consider the topic. What are you talking about? What are you doing? How are you trying to demonstrate this? And is it appropriate to have a sound effect in there? If you just want to have like a dog barking in the background as a joke or something like that, and it relates to what you just said, you might be able to pull it off. If you're a dog podcast, I'll bet you could throw it in a lot more often. And the listener in that particular case is not going to mind because they're a dog lover. So chances are you can get away with it there. Some other things you might want to consider are, again, is it appropriate? If you're talking in an interview situation, it might not be good to have sound effects. Picture yourself at a table. You, the listener, are the third person at that table. Would you really want to hear sound effects at that particular time? As clinking glasses or whatever. Dogs barking, they seem to be really common. Anything like that, would it be appropriate to that kind of interview? Probably not. So you might want to steer away from them. A couple things you can do when it comes to actually inserting sound effects. Number one, set the background, set the mood, use it in the background. Maybe a little soft music, and again, be sure to use copyrighted music, or maybe some sound effects in the background would also be appropriate. A waterfall. If you have a very soft and soothing podcast, maybe a waterfall is very appropriate. Okay, you see how they kind of go together? And that would be something that could run constantly under the background. Just make sure it's not very loud. You don't want it to be really, really in the foreground and take attention away from what you're doing, especially if it's a scene like I just did, trying to calm somebody down, they're trying to go to sleep or something like that. You don't want Niagara Falls in your ear, but a nice soft brook or something like that. So adjust your volumes as well. And whether you end up using, say, music or sound effects, just make sure they're licensed. And there are plenty of places on the internet where you can download just the cut you need, or you can sign up for an entire subscription. No matter what it is, you've at least got that receipt to back you up. And especially if you're going to be posting something to YouTube, they really need to know that everything's legit. Have you used sound effects or music in the past? If you are using it, drop a comment down below. I'd love to see what you got. And the second technique you can use for sound effects is placing it in between the lines. For example, you probably hear it a lot in, say, radio commercials. Come out for the big 4th of July celebration and watch all the fireworks. At the end of the word fireworks, you'll hear psst, and then they'll pick up with the next line. And be sure to bring the kids because we'll have, you know, autographs and face painting, you know, whatever. But they throw that in between the lines. So it kind of takes center stage there. That's perfectly fine. If there's something like that that applies to your podcast, like I said earlier, when you're on a dog podcast and you're talking about dogs and you say a joke or something like that, you can emphasize it with that sound effect. There are plenty of ways to use it either in the background or to give it attention to what you just said, to help reinforce what you just said. Another critical thing you want to pay attention to is where you actually put it in your podcast. There's a right place and a wrong place. Do you want it in between here? Do you want it in the background? The way you position it as well will help to give it the right emphasis or not. And the way to do that, especially the most popular trick, is when you bring it in and when you fade it out. When it comes to music or sound effects, I like to give it a little intro. If somebody's talking, I'll go ahead and start the sound effect here and fade it in. And then when they're done talking, it's a hair before full volume. And then just a split second later, literally a split second later, we finish it off with the top volume. We hear it, and just as it's starting to die down, we're gonna have the next line so it fades out under the talking. So like, go to the fireworks tonight. And have a great time. The sound effects are gonna help propel the entire message forward. So it's not that you're pausing down or stopping down to listen to the sound effect. You want it to carry you to the next step. That's the proper way to use it right there. Fade it in while they're talking, fade it out when the next person picks up. A couple other things that you can use that will really take your sound effects real estate is how loud you're going to make it. First of all, how loud you're going to make it. And again, a lot of it just needs to be in the background. If you're gonna have something running under the background, make sure it's soft. If you wanna give it attention, you can bring the volume up. Another thing to have a lot of fun with is, you know, people are going to be listening to your podcast, probably with earbuds, maybe speakers, but a lot of folks listen with earbuds while they're doing something else. So try this. There's a little knob in the software and it's called panning. Will it come out of the left or the right? And a very simple thing you can do is maybe have a dog bark in the left side and a cat meow in the right side and have them bounce back and forth. Now you don't want to do this too much. You don't want to pan completely to the right and to the left. Don't do that. But pan them just a little bit so you know, but let's say instead of 100%, you only need to go about 30, 35, maybe 40% at the most. Okay, that way you're still got 60% here and 40% here. It's that other side that's, both ears are gonna hear it because you've still got it in both sides, but it is going to lean to one side and it will draw them to one side or the other. So a judicious use of volume and panning can be a lot of fun. Sound effects and background music can add a lot. It can also detract. But the one thing that you really, really, really want to do, the number one thing, the purpose of a podcast is to connect with your audience. Well, I've got a free download for you that you can get right now. It's called Engaging Your Audience, the 3 secrets to skyrocket your podcast success. There's a link down below in the description section. Just click on that and go get your free one right now. I'm Nic Natarella. Thank you for watching.